While you may need to discover your talents so that you can figure out your potentials and how best to put them to use to live a happy and fulfilled life, there are a few other things that require no talent to succeed. A millionaire friend of mine, Steve Courage, once said that there are two types of skills needed to succeed in life. The first category is the hard skills. Skills are fields that you can learn and get a certification. Your practice of the skills to become an expert or a master in them will determine your success, such as designing, modeling, programming, etc. The second skill is the soft skills, skills that require no certification whatsoever, such as leadership skills, emotional intelligence. Guess what? These skills do not require any talent but effort. So in this video, I'll share with you 9 things that require no talent and can make you successful. If you're new here, consider subscribing so that you don't miss out on exciting videos like this. 1. Attitude. Ralph Waldo Emerson, an American essayist and lecturer, said, "Nothing great was ever achieved without enthusiasm." Maintaining a positive attitude is crucial if you want to succeed in life, because life itself could be stressful. So why not help yourself feel better by maintaining positivity? A famous Oprah Winfrey's quote says, "The greatest discovery of all time is that a person can change his future by merely changing his attitude." When you keep a positive attitude, not only will it help you feel great, but it will also rub off on everyone around you. Now, imagine how exciting it will be to be around positive people. The truth is that no one wants to spend so much time with people who are always unhappy or sad. However, when you are always happy or positive, people will want to work with you, creating more opportunities to explore your talent and become successful. Being positive, however, doesn't mean that you won't make mistakes. It only means that you are prepared to hold on to only the positive side of life, no matter the obstacles you face. 2. Work ethic. Your work ethic can go a long way in determining how successful you become. According to Idowu Koyenikon, even though your time on the job is temporary, if you do a good enough job, your work there will last forever. Hardworking employees with excellent work ethic get the most significant and most challenging projects, but they also get the reward that comes with it. They get raises, praises, and promotions in the company. So, while the lazy ones give one excuse or the other, people with a great work ethic stop at nothing to get their work done and done excellently. A very famous work ethic quote says that, "Don't be upset with the results you didn't get from the work you didn't do." Let me tell you what a work ethic is. A work ethic is a set of moral principles that we use in our jobs. It includes things like reliability or dependability, dedication, productivity, cooperation, character, integrity, sense of responsibility, emphases on quality, teamwork, respectfulness, determination, accountability, humility, organizational skills, and flexibility. So if you want to become successful, it'll help to start learning how to develop an excellent work ethic. To do this, start by showing up at work early, delivering on your KPIs, working through challenging situations, and getting the job done. Note that it applies to everyone, whether you are an employee or not. As an entrepreneur, it is essential to learn these skills, mainly because no one will be there to monitor your job. So, it is all up to you to do what is right and at the right time if you want your business to succeed. 3. Valuing time. Time is about the most valuable thing on earth. Next to it is money, not the other way around. So if you want to succeed, it is crucial to learn how to maximize your time and, most importantly, that of others. Here's something you should understand. People will pay you any amount of money to save their time and get their job done. For instance, say you want a beautiful suit. There are several options. 1. You could purchase your fabric of choice and get an incredibly talented designer to tailor it to your choice. 2. You could go for a finished product. 3. You could learn everything you need to learn about tailoring and designing, and then make your suit by yourself, etc. However, of all the options available, whereas option 1 and 2 will cost you money, option 3 will cost you time. So, if you were asked to pick which of both possibilities you will choose, I'm pretty sure you spend more money than time, because you could use that time to get some of the things done. Understanding the value of time and learning how to maximize time, for instance, showing up on time, will help you succeed in life. Being on time shows your coworkers and friends that you care about making the most of their time. Moreover, this habit of being punctual, once formed, will extend into your personal life, meetings with friends and family, paying a bill on time, keeping your promises, etc. 4. Teachability. You're going to have to admit that you don't know everything in life, and you'll have to learn at some point, whether it is from a friend, teacher, colleague, or even a younger one. So, how teachable are you? The ability to learn, unlearn, and relearn is one of the most fundamental attitudes in life. The ability to learn and be teachable means you are always ready to change, transform, improve, and above all, excel and succeed. When we learn, we add new skills or knowledge to what we already know. When we unlearn, we step outside of our current way of thinking and choose a different mental model. Success requires being open-minded. You should be willing to let go of old habits and processes so that you can create room for new practices and information. At first, it might not be easy to let go of some of your old habits, but with constant practice, you'll learn. Note that receiving feedback is also a way of being teachable. It means that you are ready to change and improve, and that is what teachability involves. 5. Hard work. Winston Churchill, a British statesman and writer, once said, "Continuous effort, not strength or intelligence, is the key to unlocking your potential." Research has shown that it takes about 10,000 hours to be an expert. To make that happen, it means that you have to be hardworking even when you don't feel like doing anything. Being hardworking doesn't mean that you won't make mistakes. It only means that you have to practice well enough to learn from your mistakes and become a professional. 6. Self-motivation. You see, there will always be days when you won't feel motivated to do anything. What do you do? To keep your motivation high, for example, you need to take a specific action to reach an objective. 7. Body language. Body language is a vital part of communication. You need to learn how to communicate with people, pass across the right message, whether with your words or your body language. A lot of time, communication is nonverbal, and the way you carry yourself is more important than what you say. Body language such as good eye contact, standing up straight, mirroring body postures, etc. 8. Passion. Simon Sinek, a British-born American author and motivational speaker, said, "Working hard for something you don't care about is called stress. Working hard for something you love is called passion." To make life easy for you and succeed, you have to do something that you love, something you could do all day and not get tired, and something that continually excites you. You see, no matter the field or profession you choose, you'll face hard times. You'll encounter difficulties and obstacles over time. So, how will you overcome them if you are not passionate about what you're doing? Guy Kawasaki said, "Pursuing your passion makes you more interesting, and interesting people are enchanting." 9. Being prepared. When you fail to plan, it means that you plan to fail. Opportunities mostly show up when we least expect, and most times, they don't look like it. However, when you are prepared for it, it doesn't matter what it looks like or not. Ann Landers, an American advice columnist, "Opportunities are usually disguised as hard work, so most people don't recognize them." Being prepared means that you have to invest your time and even resources in learning and improving yourself. There you go, guys. Good luck with your endeavors. Thank you very much for watching our videos. If you like this video, watch more videos on our channel and subscribe. We love you.